Tinder for me is too boring. Grindr is more fun.
You guys did have some fun?
Awesome. I'm Jael. I'm from Puerto Rico. I'm 28 years old.
Get back to your childhood. Did you live a peaceful life?
My family was very loving, but very close-minded in many ways. I come from a small island, Puerto Rico. It's a territory of the US, but it's in the Caribbean, so it's a small island. The mentality of the people is very close. Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
It's where Ricky Martin is from.
Ah, and Ricky J-Lo Martin.
Too.
Yeah. And J-Lo.
Cool people, beautiful people, and talented too.
I can see.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So your parents were a little bit close-minded, you say. How were they close-minded?
Strict too, at least my mom. So anything that could give signs of homosexuality, they will always criticize it. So I grew up with this fear, you know, about my sexuality. The point to get to accept myself, it was hard to just get to explore myself because I was scared. Of course, you think when you're a kid that everything is normal. Like you don't know what's bad. Many times kids are going through bad experiences without even realizing that they are going through something negative. And it wasn't until I started growing up more that I realized this is
wrong.
Eventually, everything changed. I was able to accept things for what they were, to forgive, and to decide to transform that hate and frustration, transform it into art. Mm. So I like to do, for example, with my performances, I like to make the people feel similar feelings of what I felt when I was a kid.
Mm. Oh.
It's so beautiful how you can say that you had a peaceful childhood. I think that's because you feel healed right now, right?
Yes, I do.
How did that make you change in your behavior as a child?
It was good in the way because I learned how to act. Yeah, I learned how to be strong. I learned how to be tough. I learned how to keep things inside of myself.
High emotion.
Yeah.
So when did you come out with your family?
So when I was 20, I moved to a different country, to Argentina, for a few months to study. The main reason was to actually be alone. I needed to be alone without friends, without family, because I needed to explore myself. And after that, I came back home. I first spoke to my friends. They were very caring, and they showed a lot of love to myself. And after that, I met my first proper gay partner. And he inspired me. He gave me the courage to talk to my family. Before, I've been always very reserved in general when it comes to sharing with my family. It was a bit sad, her reaction first from my mom.
Like she was disappointed?
She looked a little bit disappointed because she told me in that moment that my brother is also gay. So we're only two. She thought that she did something wrong. She told me that she was gonna pray a lot for God to strengthen me up, and I told her, Mom, I'm not folded, I'm not broken. This is me, this is what I am. It only has to do, I also enjoy sex with a man. That's it. But I am this, I am a man.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't change me.
Maybe she doesn't really accept it and she doesn't really support it.
In that moment, but at least to know that my mom already knew about myself and that she was fine with it.
And your father?
And he reacted really good, I would say.
What?
That. Our relationship even became better after that. I think he really showed support, and the relationship became better.
Oh,
that's
nice.
Lovely.
Yeah, it was nice.
The difficulties of being gay stopped then? Or what were you struggling about with?
I think it finished, yeah, because everything was just here inside my head.
Mm.
And then once I saw that everything was fine outside of here, everything changed.
So, about love life.
Love life?
Do you want to ask?
You went to Argentina and you met your first love?
No, my first love, I met him in Puerto Rico after that.
Puerto Rico.
We had a relationship for 4 years.
4 years.
We split it in New Zealand. And after I've spent maybe 2 years single, not wanting to know anything about love, then many of my close friends, they told me, Jael, don't be scared to love again. Don't be scared to fall in love. If it happens, flow. Go with the flow. Dare to love again. You will regret. If you don't dare to love now, maybe you will regret in the future more than regretting having a relationship.
Yeah.
So I said, okay, I'm gonna try it. But I love my freedom. I am very sexual as well, so I love enjoying my sexuality freely. Mm-hmm. But then I met up this wonderful human being here in Vietnam, from Russia. We met a first time and the connection was amazing. It was like a re-encounter. This is not just a hook, like, oh, okay, then bye-bye. This feels good. I want to keep this for a little while. We continued seeing each other, mm-hmm. and we're still together. It's almost a year already.
Wow.
9 months.
Do you want to meet him now?
Yes, is he here?
He is.
Oh, yes, around the corner. Meet him.
So Arthur. Please welcome.
Здравствуйте.
Здравствуйте.
Wow.
I'm Arthur.
Arthur.
I'm from Russia.
Russia.
I'm 37.
37. How did you guys met together?
So it was in Mui Ne, dating application.
Tinder, Grindr.
Tinder for me is too boring. Grindr is more fun.
You guys did have some fun?
Fun and a beautiful, wonderful connection.
Even without language. I didn't speak before.
Oh, really?
He didn't speak any English.
Lovely. So you guys are learning together, right?
Yeah.
Can you speak any Russian right now?
No, I just know a few bad words in Russian. But
just bad words.
And coming back to you, Arthur, what made you come to Vietnam?
Long story. Yeah, long story. I think I got tired from living in Russia.
Mm-hmm.
It's not easy for gay people.
I can imagine.
Actually, yeah. Mui Ne, it's Russian village, it's the biggest Russian community in Vietnam after Nichang, I think. And a lot of my friends still live in Mui Ne. I took my cats and...
You took your cats to Vietnam?
Cats?
What a man,
they
right?
live with us, two beautiful sphinx.
Sphinx cats? Yeah, that's the hairless
gorgeous.
Cat?
Yeah.
Wanted one. Are they here in Saigon?
Yeah, of course.
Can I come
it's
visit you and play
now.
With your cat, please? Oh my God! If they have a baby, can I have one, please?
They had surgery. They can't have babies.
Sorry.
I totally want a sphinx cat.
They're gorgeous, so elegant. They're
so
really beautiful.
I am just curious. When you first met together, what make you feel that you want to stick together till now?
It felt like we knew each other from before.
Oh.
And we just like, boop, we meet again. Soul encounter. Yeah, there's something special when someone touches you. Like, you can feel when it's just a superficial touch, when it's just a touch of lust, or when it's actually a touch of love. Many times we're scared to name or use the word love at mm-hmm. first. But sometimes we can identify when it's love since the first moment.
Yeah.
I think if it's present, it will be present since the start. And you just have to make it grow more.
When you met each other, was everything just perfect? Or was there some troubles that you met?
We were living in different cities. He was in Mui Ne, I was here in mm-hmm. Ho Chi Minh.
Did you move here?
Eventually, yeah. Or at some point at the beginning of the relationship, I lost my job. And I spent maybe 3 months without a job, so that was a bit of a hard time. And then he used like all his savings helping me for many, many, many months. But then everything just fell into place. I found a proper job after that. Since the beginning, we were also a team. When
supporting
I needed him, he supported me without thinking about it, which is another sign of love, I will say.
I guess that you guys have had a lot of good experience. So which one is the most beautiful that you can never forget it?
Really, we both have a really beautiful memory being on the rooftop of the house that I used to live before. And we were just lying on the floor
mm-hmm.
and looking to the city, to the landmark 81 from the distance. We were crying together, laughing.
It was first words about love.
Yeah, that was the first.
Because
it was the first time. Yeah, that we said to each other,
the best
"I
moment.
Love you." Yeah, and it was a really special moment. It felt really, really magical.
I can actually feel it. Like just being in your presence, I can feel that there is a strong love between you two.
Love to hear
it's
that.
It's really nice. Did your personality just fit together? Because you are Russian and you are Puerto Rican, is there any difference between your culture that made you guys clash?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
We are absolutely different. I am an absolute mess in a good way. I like to call it my beautiful chaos. I'm very creative. I'm always creating something. If it's not crafting something with my hands, it's drawing or dancing or just thinking of ideas for a next show, but I always have a mess. I used to have a mess. Now I have a mess thanks to him. He's super OCD. Everything is in order, organized. Everything has a place. Super different. This is like my style. I like weird stuff. I love skirts like this one. I don't worry too much about my physical appearance because I love how I look. So even when I look super trashy, I feel comfortable. And it's very different. He likes to always be clean, cut. I run all clothes always. So very different. I am a freedom freak. I need my freedom. So when we first met, that was one of the first things that I put to him, like, oh, you have to respect my freedom. But then eventually he did. He supported my freedom. And after I realized, like, maybe I don't need certain kinds of freedom, specifically the sexual one, let's say. So if in the future I need to open up, for example, the relationship to defend or protect my freedom, or to remember what it is to be free, I am comfortable to talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
Because I will not receive judgment. He's my partner, but he's my friend. He listens to me, helps me find solutions when I need. So that's beautiful.
And for you, how does he support you in ways? How has he opened your mind from being a strict person, always like this? What kind of qualities does he bring out in you?
He changed me a lot. Now I am less Russian than before.
Absolutely
true, yeah. Because being gay in Russia, it's so hard. It's impossible if you want to have a good job, career, future. So now it's my coming out. First.
Official one.
Today.
It's ticket on in one way.
Oh my God, that's beautiful.
My family know, few friends, few colleagues before, but not everyone.
Mm. So when you come out with your family, how did they react?
My second mother, she said me thank you. Thank you for true.
Being honest.
Yeah. My father said me I cannot judge you. I only can help you.
And your mother?
I lost my mother before I started being gay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because she was didn't like it. It was so hard connection with my mother.
It's okay, as long as you're happy right now, right?
Yeah.
And in Vietnam, would you say that you feel free right now?
Yeah. I love Ho Chi Minh. City of freedom,
right?
for me, maybe. For local people, it's not like for me.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel so free here.
Okay, well, I don't know how to ask this question. That's why you're waiting for me.
That's why I'm waiting.
So it's hard for me to ask this question, but I always get shy. Did you meet each other on Grindr and it was first time just one night stand and then you realize it's not a one night stand, or like, did you just kiss, just hold hands? What happened?
Everything happened. So we had the first encounter. As I mentioned before,
we are adults already.
Yeah,
right?
And I am very sexual, and I am very open with my sexuality. All my friends know how I am. They all respect me. So that's great, because I was with a lot of friends. When I went to Munich, I went to do a show in New Year's Eve. After meeting, it turned out that a friend that is DJ, she was a producer of this event. She knew Arthur. They had friends in common. So it was like, okay, so we do have like connections between us.
So the first time you met, you did not kiss, you did nothing. You just saw each other and you were like, we've got a mutual friend.
We kissed and we had beautiful, wonderful.
We didn't talk.
Yeah, we didn't talk. He could not speak English.
Yeah.
it was just pure physical chemistry and connection.
You know, that's the strongest, right?
Oh yes.
This, you have to have that like real feeling of attraction for your partner. Yeah.
For me, for example, it's beautiful to see how natural everything has just come out. Like, okay, but I'm this change just happened. Like, I haven't stopped to think too much about things or to decide, okay, I'm gonna be like this, I'm not gonna be like that. No, everything just flew in a beautiful way.
White guy like you and a serious guy can stick together and fit.
I think because it's very, we complement each other. I have found way more order now in my life, thanks to him, and I bring freedom to him.
Very beautiful. I kind of saw that in dating a Japanese guy too, because very much the same like you, and he has to pick up my panties.
You're the messy one.
Yeah, I'm the
poor
messy
him,
one.
Poor him, poor so, him, Alashka.
He comes to the house and he's like, "Ooh, I like the decoration." Like, what are you creating? Like a trifecta?
It's an art installation, eh?
New art.
So, what is the difficulties in your relationship?
Language barrier, right?
Yeah, I would say the language.
You said something and he was like, "No." And breakup? Was there any breakup at any point?
No. Nothing. Maybe two times we have had arguments, but everything gets solved. Like, we don't...
Oh, that's...
Yeah, it never goes to a... I would say that maybe it's actually effective that we don't have a language in common, because we don't talk...
Don't talk bad to each other, right?
Like, we just say what is necessary.
Yeah, yeah. In Russian language, I'm so sarcastic. And,
he is in English already.
Now. I think it's helped. At some point, Jael told me, too much English.
Hey, you're learning too much. Stop it. Take it slow.
So you've been here like few years in Vietnam, and can you compare the differences between LGBT community in Vietnam and other country that you experienced before?
Back home, for example, it's completely different if you are from the countryside or if you are in the capital. In the capital, people is more open-minded, but still we are very passionate. I think all Latin cultures, so there was a lot of drama, a lot of gay drama in the capital. Here, of course, I cannot know if there is drama or not, but the Vietnamese friends that I have that are gay, they live a very relaxed life. It's not the easiest thing, of course, I think, never. Right now, I would say I see a movement of queer people here in Ho Chi Minh, like growing and empowering themselves and helping other people to achieve their freedom. So I think it's going in a very good path.
I feel that a lot amongst the foreigners. A lot of the foreigners, especially like from different countries, they find that Vietnam is the place, you know? You don't feel judged. You don't feel like what I'm doing is gonna make somebody upset. You have people that are supporting you, that feel the same way as you, and amount of people is actually growing.
And it's wonderful that it's actually developing so strong. So I think it's amazing what this city will be in the future. Such amazing minds, great people here. I know that when you are the local, many times it's hard to see the positive side of things, but I like to remind at least the people that I have the honor to meet, that they are living in a great, great city. Mm-hmm.
So in the near future, do you guys have any plan that you alike together?
Yes, we have many plans. We
don't. Every day is change.
Because of him or because of you?
Because of him,
because
I think.
So I suggest Vietnam or maybe somewhere around the eastern the middle part of the earth.
Yeah, this one at least place. Vietnam, I would say, is home already.
Do you have any messages to other LGBT members?
Absolutely. Don't lose time, guys. Don't lose time. Accept what you are. So whatever we consider a problem is just a problem inside our heads. So don't be scared of accepting what you are, because the right people will come to your life. If you need to change people, do it. Don't be scared of it.